Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to Missy Lane's Book Nook. It's April this month, and April is National Laughter Month, so it is my job today to make you laugh out loud. So I brought some funny picture books into the Storytime Room today, books that I've enjoyed over the years and that I hope you will too. We have lots more here at the library, so I think you should stop in sometime this month and check out some to bring home and share at home. But let's start with a joke first. We also have lots of jokes and lots of riddle books here at the library. I like this one. It says, what game do cows play at parties? What game do cows play at parties? Do you have any thoughts? Musical chairs. You know the game musical chairs, don't you, boys and girls? Yeah, cows play musical chairs. Let's start with our story, boys and girls. A Pig Parade is a Terrible Idea. It's by Michael Ian Black. A pig parade is a terrible idea. Well, let's think about that. I love a parade. Do you like to watch parades? I love the band in the parades with all the musical instruments and the majorettes. Those are the girls that twirl the batons. And there's always fire trucks and police cars. I love a parade. But do you ever see pigs in a parade? Not usually. I've never seen pigs in a parade. So that's why this story is called A Pig Parade is a Terrible Idea. Let's find out why. Like most children, you have probably thought to yourself at one time or another, I bet a pig parade would be a lot of fun. And yes, a pig parade certainly sounds like fun. It's even fun to say, pig parade. Go ahead, say pig parade a couple of times. Pig parade, fun, right? After all, what could be more fun than gathering a few hundred pigs together for a grand parade and then watching them proudly march together in perfect formation down the finest boulevard of your hometown? Is that how it would go? Is that what it would look like? Pigs all marching together in beat, in unison? I don't know if it would be like that. Yeah, the only problem is a pig parade is a terrible idea. For one thing, pigs hate to march. They prefer to snuffle, which is kind of like walking with your nose. Snuffling is fine when trying to find leftover apple skins and acorns around the barnyard, but snuffing is simply an inappropriate way to conduct yourself along a parade route. You can't snuffle down the street. You have to march when you're in a parade. And pigs, they don't know how to march. That's just one reason why a pig parade is a terrible idea. Also, pigs absolutely refuse to wear majorette uniforms, even if you are able to find enough majorette uniforms for all of your pigs. Which is a very difficult job in and of itself. Just try getting those hundreds of pigs to put them on. That would be tricky, wouldn't it, boys and girls? To dress them in the majorette uniform? Yeah, I don't see that working out too well. They will not do it. Perhaps they consider majorette uniforms unflattering. Nonsense. Everybody looks sharp in a majorette uniform, even pigs, especially pigs. But when you try explaining that to them, they just look at you as if you're speaking a language they do not understand. So again, a pig parade is a terrible idea. You cannot have a parade without floats, right? Well, forget it. Pigs don't care about floats. Pigs don't care about all the time and energy you spend creating a Three Little Pigs float or a Wilbur the Pig from Charlotte's Web float. In fact, the only floats pigs care about are root beer floats, which they love. Have you ever had a root beer float? root beer soda with ice cream inside. Pigs would like that. And then there's the matter of music. Pigs have horrible taste in music. If you give a group of pigs marching band instruments to play, do you think they will play good, spirited marching band music? Look, he doesn't even know what to do. He's going inside the trombone instead of blowing out of the mouthpiece. And he doesn't know how to hold this flute. They don't know what to do with a trumpet or a trombone or any of it. So no, they will not. They will play sad, sad country music ballads with titles like My Tears Are Wet Cause My Mud's Gone Dry and I Just Want to Plop Into This Bucket of Slop. That kind of music is fine for slow dancing at hoedowns, but it is not appropriate for a parade. Face it, a pig parade is what, boys and girls? A terrible idea. You got it. Finally, there are giant balloons to consider. Everybody knows that giant balloons are the best part of any parade. Well, who do you think is going to hold all those balloons to keep them from flying away? The pigs, right? Wrong. Even if pigs wanted to hold the balloons instead of finding filthy puddles on the street to lie in, they couldn't do it. Because while pig hooves are good for digging up wild mushrooms, when it comes to holding giant parade balloons, they are simply not up to the job. Yeah, they couldn't hold balloons with their little pig hooves. And what happens when the balloons go unattended? They bump into buildings or simply drift off into outer space, which would be fine for Martians, but awful for those of us trying to enjoy a pig parade here on Earth. Look at that giant pig balloon floating into outer space. Uh-oh. That one sure did go up, 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 up and away. So, when you consider the constant snuffling, the refusal to wear majorette uniforms, the disinterest in pig-themed literary floats, pigs' preference for weepy country ballads, and their utter lack of discipline regarding proper balloon holding, it should be absolutely, completely, and totally clear that a pig parade is a terrible idea. Just not gonna work. But a panda bear parade, on the other hand, would be fantastic. You think panda bears could do it? Would the panda bears put on the uniforms? Would they march to the music? I don't know. Pig parade, panda parade. But everybody loves a parade. All right, boys and girls, so we're going to take a short little break before we go on to the next story. But I want to take a moment to show you this little clip from Monday morning's Giggle and Wiggle class. You can sing along at home to I'm a Little Teapot with the rock and roll version. So don't forget to break out your air guitar. You can keep those shakers for the teapot song. We got our handle and our spout. We're gonna tip over and then we're gonna rock it out. So play that air guitar. I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is my handle. Here is my spout. Tip me over and pour me out. Go! I'm a rock and roller. Listen to me sing. When I have my guitar, when I have my guitar, I can play that thing. When I have my guitar, I can play that thing. I'm a little teapot. Short and stout. Here is my handle. Here is my spout. Here is my spout. When I get a seat, tip me over and pour me out. Good job. Big clap. All right, everybody. I hope you liked that song. It's a catchy one, isn't it? We're going to go ahead and read another funny story. This one is by Robert Munch, and it's called More Pies. Who likes a pie? Maybe a banana pie, an apple pie, blueberry pie, perhaps. Well, this little boy in this story can't get enough pies. He loves them. More pies. Samuel woke up really hungry. He went downstairs and ate a bowl of cereal. Chicka 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 chomp. And then he said, "Mom, can I please have some more?" "Yes," said his mom. "You are a growing boy and you need to eat." So Samuel's mom gave him another bowl of cereal, two milkshakes, and a stack of pancakes. Samuel ate it all really fast. Chicka 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 chomp. Wow, that was a huge breakfast. Then Samuel said, "I'm still hungry. Could I please have some more?" "Yes," said his mom, "but I think this will be enough." So Samuel's mom got out a really big salad bowl, filled it full of cereal, and gave him two milkshakes, three stacks of pancakes, and a fried chicken. Samuel ate it all really fast. Chicka 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 chomp. Whoa. That's a lot of food, boys and girls. How could he eat all of that? Could he really be that hungry? Have you ever been that hungry in the morning? You have? Well, then Samuel said, "I'm still really hungry. Could I please have seven fried chickens?" "Seven fried chickens!" yelled his mom. "Enough is enough. Nothing more to eat until lunch. Go out and play." So Samuel went outside and rolled around in the grass, yelling, "Starving! Starving! Help! I'm starving!" Samuel's little brother came running outside and he said, "Samuel, if you're so hungry, why don't you go to the pie eating contest? There's one at the fair today in the park." So Samuel got on the bus and he went to the park. Samuel walked right to the middle of the pie eating contest and he said, "Give me pies." A judge looked at Samuel and said, "You're just a little kid. Go home." A fireman, a lumberjack, and a construction worker were sitting at a long table. The construction worker said, "It won't hurt to let this kid eat a pie." So Samuel climbed on a chair, and the judge gave everybody one blueberry pie. And then the judge yelled, "One, two, three, eat!" And they all ate their pies really, really fast. Chicka 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 chomp. When they were done, the lumberjack said, "Oh, my tummy hurts." And he turned purple and he fell under the table. Uh-oh. The judge said, "Samuel, that was excellent eating, but surely you are done. You're just a little kid." Samuel said, "I'm not starving anymore, but more pies still sound like a good idea." So the judge gave everybody two peach pies, and he yelled, "One, two, three, eat!" And they all ate their pies really fast. Chicka, 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 chomp. When they were done, the fireman said, "Oh, my tummy hurts." He turned green and fell under the table. The judge said, "I don't believe this." And he gave Samuel, the construction worker, each three cherry pies. And he yelled, "One, two, three, eat!" And they ate their pies really, really fast. Chicka, 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 chomp. When they were done, the construction worker said, "Oh, my tummy hurts." He turned blue and fell under the table. "Amazing," said the judge. "Samuel wins first prize. Samuel wins the prize pie." Samuel took his prize pie, got on the bus, and went back home. Look how big that pie is. He went back home for lunch. When he walked into the kitchen, his mom said, "Samuel, I know you're really hungry, so I made pies for lunch."
"Pies?" said Samuel.
"Oh, my tummy hurts."
He turned green and fell under the table.
But Samuel's little brother said, "Yum! Pies!"
And he ate the pies really fast. Chicka, 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 chomp. The end. Look, it's his little brother entering the contest. That sure was a lot of pies.
All right, boys and girls, we're going to take another short break, go back to our giggle and wiggle session, and I want you to enjoy this song called Go Bananas. Feel free to go bananas at home. Together. Banana split. You're going to stretch your legs out as far as they will go. Banana. Like this. Oh boy. Feel that stretch. Okay. Start down low. Grow, grow bananas. Grow, grow bananas. Grow, grow bananas. Grow, grow bananas. Good. Let's pick them. Pick bananas. Pick, pick bananas. Pick, pick bananas. Good. Ready? Peel them. Okay, are you hungry? Let's eat them. Eat, eat bananas. Eat, eat bananas. Eat. Here it comes. You ready? Do it again. Start down low. Grow, grow bananas. Grow, grow bananas. Grow, grow bananas. Grow, grow bananas. Pick them. Get the ones up really high. Jump if you have to. Pick, pick bananas. Pick, pick bananas. Good. Peel them. Get ready to eat it. Ready? Eat, eat bananas. Here it comes. Ready? That was crazy.
And we're back. Do you know what it means when you go bananas? I forgot to mention, it means when you go kind of crazy, you go silly. And we like to act really silly Monday mornings here at the library. So if you've never come to a giggle and wiggle session, you ought to come and check one out. Let's move on to a third funny story. It's called It's a Tiger by David LaRochelle, another author who writes a lot of funny stories. I hope you like this one. You don't see any tigers around here, do you? There's no tigers living in Bethel Park, are there? No, so we should be safe to read this story. Tigers live in the jungle or in the zoo. Are you ready for a story? Me too. We'll start in the jungle where the tall trees grow and the monkeys swing from vine to vine. Wait a minute. That's not a monkey. That looks like... Look, boys and girls, monkey, monkey... Monkey, monkey, monkey. Is that a monkey? What is that? Monkeys usually don't have
orange and black striped tails. What is that? A tiger! Run! Push aside these vines and we'll hide in this cave. Duck your head. Flap, 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 and watch out for the bats. I don't know about you, but those shadows are making me nervous. In fact, one of those shadows looks like... What does this shadow here look like, boys and girls? Could it be? I hope not. It is a tiger! How did he get here? Hurry, climb that ladder and we'll make our escape. Ah, sunshine. Doesn't that feel good? Uh-oh. Snakes. Hundreds of them. Well, if we're very quiet, we can tiptoe past. Blue snakes, green snakes, even a great big fuzzy snake that looks just like... What, boys and girls? I see blue snakes, green snakes. What is this snake? That looks just like a tiger! Run! Yikes! Yikes! He's gaining on us! Our only chance is to leap for that rope and swing across this canyon. Now let's go! Womp! We made it! Good thing we landed on someplace soft. A bed of flowers? A pile of leaves? A giant orange and black pillow? No, we landed on top of a tiger! Now we are really in trouble. Quick, climb this rock and slide down the hill. Bumpity bumpity bump bump bump. Yes, yes, a boat. Hop on deck and raise the anchor. Full steam ahead, Captain. Phew. Safe at last. Say, I've never seen a sea captain with a tail before. Have you? Here's the ship that they're climbing on. There's the captain. What is that tail sticking out? You don't think it could be a tiger? Oh, not again. Why, that tiger's following us everywhere. Jump overboard, or he'll eat us up as lunch. Swim, swim, splash, splash, splash. I know you're tired, but don't slow down. Whew, we're in luck. There's an island and a chest. Open the lid. I bet we'll find... I see two eyes peeping out. Who do you think's in that chest, or what do you think is in that chest?
I hope it's not a...
I hope it's not a tiger! And he wants to eat us!
Roar!
Uh-oh. Wait a minute. He doesn't want to eat us. He was only yawning. If we scratch his ears and rub his belly, maybe he'll go to sleep. Better yet, let's tell him a story. We'll start in the jungle, where the tall trees grow and the monkeys swing from vine to vine. Wait a minute. That's not a monkey. That looks like... What? Monkey, 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 monkey. Huh? Who's that green tail belong to? That's not a monkey. That's a crocodile! Uh-oh, here we go again. I hope that crocodile doesn't follow him everywhere. It was bad enough trying to escape that tiger. Phew. All right, boys and girls. All right, boys and girls, let's jump back to that giggle and wiggle. I'm going to have you watch another song, one of my favorites. It's a balancing song called the Beanbag Song. And if you want to try it at home, boys and girls, try to balance something on your head. It doesn't have to be a beanbag. Maybe you can even just put maybe a washcloth up there. Or if you have a book at home, Can you try balancing a book on your head? That's a little trickier, but I bet you can do it. Have fun practicing your balancing and listening to the beanbag song.
Throw the beanbag and catch. Turn around, turn around. Stamp, stamp, stamp. Throw the beanbag and catch. Turn around, turn around. Stamp, stamp, stamp. Walk around the room. Good balancing. Yes. Move five. Get ready. And catch. Turn around, turn around. Stamp, stamp, stamp. Throw the bean bag. And catch. Turn around, turn around. Stamp, stamp, stamp. Walk around the room. Chin up, it'll help balance. Look straight ahead. Very good. Excellent. Put it on your shoulder. Put it on your elbow. Put it on your knee. Put it on your back now. Put it on your stomach. Put it on your fingers. Put it on your foot. Whoop. You okay, sweetheart? You okay? Good job balancing. Get ready. And catch. Turn around, turn around. Stamp, stamp, stamp. Throw the beanbag. And catch. Turn around, turn around. Stamp, stamp, stamp. Again. And catch. Turn around, turn around. Stamp, stamp, stamp. Last time. And catch. Turn around, turn around, stamp, stamp, stamp. Another big round of applause. Great job.
Well, boys and girls, thanks for laughing out loud with me today. I hope you found these books funny. Let's end with another joke. Take out my handy dandy joke book. Oh, you've always heard of the chicken jokes, right? Why did the chicken cross the road? Here's one for you. Why did the chicken cross the clothing store? To get to the other size. Not side, to get to the other size. Get it? He's in a clothing store. All right, boys and girls. Again, happy National Laughter Month. Thanks for watching Miss Elaine's Book Nook, and I'll see you next month. Take care.